Pleasant greetings from Vidyavardhini's College of Engineering and Technology, Vasai. I am Shubham Chaudhary along with my partner Jayashree Patil, and we are going to present on the topic Identification of Groundwater Potential Zones using GIS techniques in Vasai Taluka. As we all know, humans have been facing acute water shortages for a very long time. Now, there might be confusion that even though the 3/4 earth is covered with water, how is there so less water to be? How are we facing such crisis? Because only 1% of this water can be used, and which is only available in glaciers, rivers, lakes, and rain. But there is one more source that is very close to us and which has been used for centuries by us humans, that is groundwater. But again, groundwater is not available in abundance everywhere, and we are here to determine that with this project of ours. Now, our aim of the project is to determine groundwater potential zones of Vasai Taluka using ArcGIS 10.5 software. Objectives: to develop thematic map of drainage density, lineament density, geology, geomorphology, slope, soil, rainfall, land use, and land cover, and to depict groundwater potential zones and to study groundwater potential information usefulness for effective identification and of suitable location for extraction of water. Now, if you talk about the problems, why we actually have to do this project is because many a times people invest a lot of their energy, time, and money in building sources through which groundwater can be extracted. However, not every place has abundant groundwater, and this project will effectively help people to determine that. Also, in the construction industry, when we have to lay down the foundation, while digging up the ground, if there is excess amount of groundwater, it becomes a hindrance for the project. And thus, we can help the construction industry by determining places where excess groundwater exists, and they can be ready to move the water effectively. About the study area. So our study area is Vasai Taluka, which is situated in Palghar district of Maharashtra. On its north, there is a river, and its south, there is a creek. The total area of this region is 544 square kilometers, and the highest elevation is 620 meters.
Let's have a look on project methodology. For conducting this study, we need to find out these 8 factors which are going to affect groundwater potential zones: slope, drainage density, lineament density, geomorphology, geology, land use, land cover, soil, and rainfall. For creating the maps of these factors, we require different kinds of input data like satellite data and collateral data. For slope drainage density and lineament density, the input map is the same, that is DEM, digital elevation model. And for rest like geomorphology, soil, land use, land cover, and rainfall, every map requires different kinds of input data accordingly. After getting all these 8 maps, we require to get that one final map which is showing us groundwater potential zones, and that is done by wetted overlay analysis. Next, as I mentioned before, 3 factors digital elevation, for this 3 factors, digital elevation model is the input. Digital elevation model is 3D representation of terrain surface. So we downloaded this DEM from Bhuvan. It is ISRO's official website. Our project area was lying between these 2 satellite images. So we opened this in ArcGIS 10.5 and merge it in one single image. And then we extracted our study area from this. This is how it looks like. This is how the DEM map looks like. Next, first influencing factor is slope. Basically, slope is the rate of change of elevation, and it plays significant role in groundwater potential as it determines the gravity effect on water movement. So we created this slope map in software with spatial analyst surface toolset. It is classified in 5 classes from 0 to 89.99, and the color coding is given accordingly from lower to higher slope. Drainage density, it shows water bodies, streams, ponds, etc. present in particular area. For creating drainage density, we have used hydrologist tool set in our software, and later we perform various functions to get this map. As same as slope, it is classified in 5 classes from low to high drainage density. Next is lineament density. Basically, lineaments are the fractures present on the surface of ground through which water percolates in groundwater system. So, area with excellent lineament density is good for groundwater. As you can see in this first image, this is how the hillshed effect looks like. It shows the lines and fractures present on the study area. As you can see in this second image, we have drawn some lines on the fractures, and that is how the lineament density map is prepared. Fourth is land use, land cover. Land use is man's activity on land, and land cover is vegetation, water bodies present in the study area. For creation of this map, we obtained the input data from USGS Earth Explorer in the form of Landsat 8. You can see in this first image, the green color portion present over there is our Vasai Taluka. So by performing various functions and image classification, we successfully prepared this land use land cover map. In this, red color is showing us the urban land, blue color is showing us the water, green indicating vegetation, and white showing barren land. Next is rainfall. As we all know how rainfall is interrelated with groundwater, as it determines the amount of water percolating in groundwater system. So we obtain this rainfall data from CHRS data portal. It is in the form of CSV and it is from 2010 to 2020. That is how the rainfall maps looks like. Next is geomorphology. Geomorphology of any area is important geographic unit, landforms and underlying geology. It is one of the most important parameter in the groundwater study as it is helpful for planning, development and management of groundwater resources. After going to various sites for data, we obtain this data from BHUCOSH, that is Geological Survey of India. You can see in this first image, the green color, red color portion is a study area present on the data. The major landforms are a structural lower plateau in purple color and pediment and pediplain in ochre yellow color and rest are the small landforms. Next is geology. Geology is basically rocks present in the region. Same as the geomorphology, geology map was prepared in software by Cliff Function. We have only one type of formation present over here, that is Deccan Traps. And last factor of our study is soil. Soil is the primary factor which determines amount of water going in groundwater. So soil data was downloaded from FOA United Nations. This is how the soil maps looks like. It has three types of soils, cambium soils, fluvisoils, and nitisoils. Next, weighted overlay analysis. The last and final stage of our project. Basically, what it does is, it is the human judgment interpolated with analysis. So in this, weights are assigned to each of the maps according to their influence and potentiality on groundwater. It is ranked from 1 to 5 as very poor, poor, moderate, high, and very high. These weights we have given as per the judgment of researchers who has done work on the similar project previously. Next. So this table is showing us the ranks and weights given to all of the 8 layers in weighted overlay analysis. The highest and most important impactful factors, rainfall, slope and geomorphology having ranks 22, 19 and 16 respectively. This is how it is done. Next, after doing weighted overlay analysis, the outcome we get is this map. The zone showing groundwater potentiality in our study area. So we divided this map in 3 classes as low, moderate and high. So in this, red color is showing us the low groundwater zone. As we can see, it is very less. Then the moderate potential zone is green color and the whole study area is almost covered with the moderate groundwater potential zones. And the darkest blue color is high amount of groundwater present over here. This is how the study helped us to depict groundwater in Vasai Taluka.
So these are some of our references that we visited through and we have gone through and finally got our help and outputs. So in the end, when we finally did the entire project, we realized that GIS is a very helpful software, not only for this particular project, but also in many other projects too. About this particular project, it is like a one-time investment and it can help us in determining such factors, not only of your very own place or your very own nation, but all around the world. This project is completely of low cost. Only the cost would be for the software. Except for that, everything and every data is really very easily available on the internet. And entire project becomes very helpful for people who are dependent on groundwater. So in the end, we would like to thank you.
Thank you.